Lives in a pineapple under the sea. That's not right.
SpongeBob SquarePants. What are you?
He's not right either.
Oh, wait a minute. That guy says that's how I'm supposed to wear the mask? He's always right. Okay. There we go. Yeah, I feel safer already. These other people have no idea what they're doing. I'm always right.
SpongeBob SquarePants.
I'm out of coffee. All right.
Okay. That's fine. I'm fine. Gonna go get some coffee, and I'm safe. That's what's important. Everything is fine. Everything is fine. Just gonna get my coffee. Great. It's coming. I get everything. I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm just gonna get some coffee. That's all I need to do. I'm doing so good. I'm so great.
Nick! What? What? You got coffee all over me. What are you doing?
Kids, we're going to sing Me and My Friends. Stand up and let's do some motions.
One, two, ready, go.
Me and my friends, we're gonna serve the Lord. Me and my friends, we're gonna love the Lord. Me and my friends, we're gonna dance. We're gonna dance for the Lord. Friends, we're gonna praise. We're gonna praise the Lord. So we sing, 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 we shout, shout, shout. Jesus is our King. So we sing, 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 we shout, shout, shout. Let the praises ring.
Nice. Do you think they can maybe sing a little louder?
Yeah.
You think so? Let's give them another chance. You ready?
Me. My friends, we're gonna serve the Lord. Me and my friends, we're gonna love. We're gonna love the Lord. Me and my friends, we're gonna dance. We're gonna dance for the Lord. Me and my friends, we're gonna praise the Lord.
Here we go!
So we sing, sing, sing. We shout, shout, shout. Jesus is our King. So we sing, sing, sing. We shout, shout, shout. Let the praises ring.
Here we go.
So we sing, sing, sing. We shout, shout, shout. Jesus is our King. So we sing, sing, sing. We shout, shout, shout. Let the praises ring.
Good
job, guys! Nick, you want to build some stuff out of Legos?
For sure.
Sweet. So you finally got your cup of coffee you were after?
Yeah, I'm a little soggy bottom here.
Gotta say, I'm a little wet myself. My wife's gonna say, "You smell like coffee." Dude, you were wearing a mask on your eyes. What was that all about?
Yeah, it was.
Can't believe nobody else knows how to wear masks the right way. I'm the only person I know that...
The right way? I'm sorry. You're saying that everyone else wears it wrong?
Yeah. I'm the only person I know that's wearing it the right way.
You were wearing it on your eyes.
I know. Listen, there's this guy on YouTube that I follow. He's super smart. He always knows exactly what he's talking about. And he's the one. He told me. I saw it on his video, his latest video. Like, I should be wearing the mask on my eyes.
Dude, that is like the blind leading the blind. It reminds me of what Jesus was talking about in Luke. We gotta be careful who we listen to, like who's our leader and who we follow. Like, it's interesting that you're telling me that everyone else is wrong, but you're right?
Yeah.
It doesn't sound very humble. I think Jesus has a lot to talk about this. How about this? Go get your Bible, or any Bible. I mean, we're at church. There should be a Bible around here somewhere. Go get a Bible. Come back. Let's look up Luke 6. We're in the book of Luke now. Here's a church. Done with 1 Peter. I think Jesus has got some things to say.
All right. I'll go get it.
Hey, Outward Kids. We're going to stand and we're going to sing another song. So during this song, what I want you to be thinking about and what we should be asking God is, God, what are you trying to teach me right now? What are the truths about you that you are going to write on my heart? Open the eyes of our hearts so that we can learn those things, all right? Let's sing this next song together. Here we go. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart. Here we go. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up. See you high and lifted up. Shining in the light of your power, pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. Sing out holy. Holy, holy, holy. You are holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy, holy. Job, let's sing the whole thing again. Are you ready? Here we go. Open the eyes. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up. To see you high and lifted up.
All right. Got it.
All right. So check out Luke 6. So we're back in the book of Luke, chapter 6. Jesus is giving like the Sermon on the Mount. Okay. And it's in verse 39.
You want me to read it?
Yeah, read it.
Okay. 39 says, Jesus told them a parable.
Parable's like a story, okay? He spoke in a story so that you'd think about what he's saying.
Verse 39 says, Jesus told them a parable. Can a blind man lead a blind man?
That's what I was talking about, blind leading the blind.
Oh, okay. Will they not both fall into a pit? A disciple is not above his teacher, but everyone, when he is fully trained, will be like his teacher. Why do you see the speck that is in your brother's eye, but do not notice the log that is in your own eye? How can you say to your brother, "Brother, let me take out the speck that is in your eye," when you yourself do not see the log that is in your own eye? You hypocrite. First, take the log out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to take out the speck that is in your brother's eye. Log in my eye? Brandon, that's not even possible. I'd be dead.
No, it's a story, right? So it's like exaggerated truth to help you see what Jesus is trying to say. I gotta say this gently because I love you, I care about you, but you're being super judgmental. Like looking at everyone saying they're wrong and I'm right. I feel like, kind of like what Jesus is talking about, you got this giant log in your eye and you're looking at the specks in everyone else's.
That story was helpful. I guess I never really thought about it that way.
I mean, you make mistakes, don't you?
Well, I don't. I'm usually pretty right. A lot of the stuff that I think is usually pretty right.
It may be true, but the book of Proverbs says that the way of a fool seems right in his own eyes. I think Jesus is pointing the blindness. I think he's pointing out the fact that we're blind to our own wrongness. Like we can't even see it. It feels right. It looks right. And so we assume we're right. And so it's like the blind leading the blind. We both have, we're both wrong, right? Some of the times we're wrong. And we both have this blindness. And so for you to say that you're right and I'm wrong, or me to say that I'm right and you're wrong, it's like the blind leading the blind. We need to find a good teacher who can help us to see where we're blind. You know, every time that you do get it wrong, you've been shown grace. You've been forgiven, either by your parents, but definitely by God, by Jesus. Every time that you get it wrong, you're forgiven.
I guess that's true. I have been wrong on things in the past, even when I initially thought that I was right.
Jesus actually talked about this in one verse prior to this parable. He says that the amount that you forgive is the amount that you'll be forgiven. Another way of thinking of that is when you see how much you've been forgiven, it makes it easier to forgive other people. So rather than sitting there and judging everyone and saying you're wrong and you're wrong and you're wrong, you realize I've been wrong too.
Yeah.
And I've been forgiven. The more you realize that you're wrong and that you've been forgiven, you can forgive others. And you don't sit there and be super judgy about what other people are doing.
Yeah, I mean, the grace that I have been given, I think you're saying, is the grace that I should extend to other people.
That's exactly right. Jesus is saying that the biggest problem is not the sin of other people, but your own sin. You should be thinking about how God has forgiven you and he's still working on you, changing you, making you look more like Jesus. Before we worry about other people's sin, focus more on our own.
Yeah. Thanks for talking to me about this, Brandon. I think that I need to pray and ask God to help me realize how much grace has been given to me.
Hey, you bet, man. You want to go ride skateboards in front of a green screen?
Yeah, I do. All right.
You riding a skateboard or working with a hula hoop there?
Nobody knows.